guys, and welcome to another pinstriping episode series, Pinstriping Basics. In this episode, we're gonna carry on with our scrolls and scroll designs, because we had quite a lot of interest from the previous episode, so we're gonna carry on doing that today. However, we won't be scrolling that much. If it's confusing, you need to join me for the ride and I'll explain you what we're gonna do. But basically, we're gonna work with the very same brush, the Wizard Vortex number one, and I'm gonna try to teach you a little bit more about the brush control itself. So we're gonna do some different designs today that we're gonna use later on for scrolling. It's gonna come very, very handy in the next episodes when we're actually gonna build a full scrolling design. So let's see how that goes. When it comes to this guy over here, you guys had a lot of questions to him, but there's some news from him. He told me today that he found a girlfriend online. It's true. So the rumor is that he'll be moving out soon at some point from the garage, but I don't know how much true that is, so we need to see what happens with that. Alright guys, let's get stuck in, see what happens. Thanks. Okay, so we have our Wizard Vortex number one, fully loaded. Once again, reminder, paint consistency and paint viscosity, as we explained in a different episode, is the key over here, especially for scrolling designs. So that's the thing you need to just practice. As I said, you know, we just need to develop that sweet spot that works for you. So we can use the same brush we used before for doing the circular designs, staying on the tip of the brush. And we're going to do some different patterns with it today. I'll show you what this little guy can do. And all these patterns, basically practicing these patterns, will develop very good brush control. So hopefully that will help us later on while building the actual scrolling design, putting these little feather lines and teardrops, you know, to it. So let's start with the first one. Hopefully this first one you are familiar with, because we've done exactly the same teardrop design with the other brush, with the sword liner, and the principle about it is the same. What we do, we just press the tip of the brush down. Once it's down, you press it hard, quite harder, and when you pull in it down the line, you reduce the distance from your practice board until it becomes really, really thin. And that is your basic teardrop. So what I want you to do, just keep doing that for, like, you know, just same as practicing straight lines. You just do 50 a day, do 100 a day, as many as you can. Put a tip down, press it hard, and once you pull it in out, just release that pressure and remove the distance from your practice panel. And you have consistent results like this. And one more. Pulling it down, and while I'm pulling it away, I'm just releasing that pressure, so just the tip stays on the ground. And that's what I want you to do. Just keep doing some of the teardrop designs. Simple, right? I give you a couple of more of the same design from a different angle, so maybe you can pick it up a little bit better. So brush fully loaded, put a tip down, press it harder. And then while you're pulling it away, get distance from the boards, reduce the distance and release the pressure. Yeah, one more over here, right next to it. Classic teardrop design. All the brush down, and once I'm going with it, once you pull on that line, release the pressure. And you got beautiful teardrops over here. Okay, one more. All the way down. And slightly up. Right, next thing we're gonna do, just a little bit of variation of this simple teardrop. So let's say, I'm not sure what the best angle here, guys, is. I may be going a little bit across the practice board, but just to give you the best view from the camera. I need to keep it on the little tripod, so it's not exactly easy to work, but I'm doing my best. So let's say we got the main
the main pin drop right over here. So I'm pressing it down and pull it, pull the line, release that pressure, and we got the main teardrop right over here. So what I would like to do right now is do teardrops on each side of the design, starting left to right and left to right, but reducing the size of them and the thickness of them. So let's say this is our central line, is the biggest one, so we're going to do similar three or four on each side of it, but reducing the size and maybe the thickness of it if possible. So let's have a look if we can achieve this. So I'm going to go probably 3/4 way on the left, press it down, and then pull down, release that pressure, do the same on the other side, press down, release the pressure, and then go on the other side, 3/4 or maybe halfway down, another smaller one, and one on the other side. Yeah, and maybe a couple more over here, small one, small one, until you can get really, really tiny. Now just the tip of the brush is usually enough, and the little dots just to make it a bit more special. I hope that makes sense. Just make a central line and a kind of developed design, go to the left, to the right, to the left, to the right. Unless you left-handed, then you start on the right and on the left, as we explained before. So let's try this for the next exercise, and you can make the first one really, really big, so all the other ones are easy to do as well, because they're going to be not so small, and you can fit, let's say, 10 to 15 of them on each side. But then you can do a really small one as well, and just do two or three on each end. Yeah, so let's try that next. So the previous exercise was quite simple, right? I mean, you're just repeating the teardrop design over and over again. You just make it slightly smaller and try to keep the symmetry on each end similar. But that's very good, because it develops brush control and develop your eye for symmetry as well, which is great. So right now we're going to make it a little bit more pretty. We're going to start the same way. We do a teardrop design in the middle. One big fat one line over here. So press down, and I pull away, and I just reduce the distance. There you go. And right now what I want to do, I want to do the same thing I did before. Do a teardrop on each end of that line, but we try to bend it slightly towards the end, so it's not straight all the way through. We try to bend it. And if you remember on the previous exercise with a sword liner, I told you to twist and turn that brush in your between your fingers when you go around the corner. Well, with this bad boy, we don't need to do that. It will do the job for us. So let's start on the left. Let's say I go like 3/4 of the way. So I press it down quite harder. And once I'm releasing, I'm just basically going towards the center of that line. Don't need to connect it. This is just fine. If you want to connect it, you can do later on, but that's a different story. And I try to repeat the same thing on the other end. So more the same distance, press it down hard, and once I'm releasing the pressure, pulling the line, I'm going towards the center of design. So there we go. And carry on this way, basically. Go 3/4 of the way or halfway through. It depends what works for you. Just for the purpose of the exercise, and do the same thing over and over. And to the other side, press down hard, and once you go in, go towards the center. And a couple more over here, and one more over here on this end. Obviously, the more you practice, the closer you'll be able to get with these designs together. I'm keeping the distance quite further apart right now, just to show you, but you'll be able to get really, really small results in the end, and get them really tight. So yeah, that's another thing I wanted to practice. Just do a center line and then curve them slightly, one towards another. Yeah, simple, right? Okay, since this one was a little bit more complicated than the other one, I thought I'd give you a different view or different angle on that. So once again, I'll do my teardrop in the middle, center design, right here. And then I'll do on the left, I press down, and as I go down, to go towards the middle of my design, and the same thing on the right hand side. Press down. Once I go down, goes to the middle of design. Look, notice I'm not turning and twisting my brush in my fingers whatsoever. I just press it down, and once the brush goes down, I just guide it towards the middle of the design, and it is as simple as that. And you can have fun with these. You can go it halfway through, you can go three quarters way down, whatever works best for you. This is just about to develop the control over your brush and this consistency of the lines. Once again, I try to take you for a ride. So press down, the ones down, go towards the center, same here, down once you release towards the center of the line. This is a beauty of this brush. You don't need to worry about going too much about go around the corners. You just guide it and the brush will do all the hard work for you. Okay, now we covered this teardrop design and some way of practicing that to make practice a little bit more fun. I'd like to introduce you to a little brother of it. I call it the feather design or wing design. I'm not really sure what the professional name for it is, but it's very much like teardrop, apart from little detail on top. It's slightly pointer. Pointer end on the top on the beginning when you start the design, it's slightly more pointing. To get the good result with that, you need to knock off some paint from the tip of your brush. Because right now, as you can see how heavy it is, it's fully loaded with paint, so it's dropping down and the paint gets everywhere, all the way from the bottom to the tip of the brush. And to get that really skinny design on the front, on the top, you need to knock some paint off from the top of the brush. And the best way to do it, it's not on where you're actually paletting your brush, but get a piece of paper or your palette when it's got no paint on it and just knock it off. You can knock it off from the whole brush, but you can knock it off just from the tip of the brush. Knocking up from the tip of the brush, you need to turn it, twist it gently until it loses lots of paint from the tip of the brush. And now you can see the tip is very pointy. Yeah, once we got this very pointy tip, get you over here. What I want you to do is nearly the same thing as with a teardrop design, with one difference. When you press that tip down, yeah, don't push all the way down with your brush. Just keep it going, just a little bit, and once you're there, then press it down, yeah? Once you press it down, the procedure is exactly the same. You just go down, you pull that line, and you release that pressure. And that gives you this little pointy edge, which is slightly different than the teardrop design. Teardrop is more rounded. And if you see some imperfections in the design, you can always come back and fix it up a little bit, you know, just one way or the other. Sometimes there's some inconsistent results. So there's no rule. Nothing tells you you cannot go back there and fix it. Nothing has to be done perfect in one go. You know, we do it by hand. And imperfection is the mother of it all, but you can always come back and fix it so it looks 100% as it should be. Yeah. Let's do this again. So my brush is fully loaded with paint. You can see the tip is quite fat, and if I want to do this very, very gentle, very sharp point, I'm gonna have difficult time doing that. So what I want to do, just get off the paint of the brush just slightly. So I'm going on my palette paper, or this nice lady over here on her bottom, and just leaving some paint, you know, on her bottom, so my tip is not as heavy. And then when I want to go with my feather design or feather drop or however you want to call it, push the tip down, but I don't push the whole brush all the way down. Push the tip down, drag it gently, depends how long you want that feather to be, and then press it down. Once it's down, the procedure is the same. You pull it and you release that pressure. And you got beautiful photo design. And there's a quite significant difference between this and the teardrops. Teardrop would be a straight down, quite far on the top, and I go down, right? And as I said, you can fix it a little bit over here. So there's a bit of a difference between the feather and the teardrop. It will be specifically very, very visible when we go around the corners, which is very handy later on in the scrolling design. But we get to that in the next episode. Okay, so same drill again, making practice a little bit more fun. So we're gonna carry on with our feather drop design. And we're gonna make a little design out of it, just like we did before with the teardrop. So you press down, I knocked some paint off the tip already. You press down gently, let it ride a little bit, then you press it, and our middle piece is done, just like that. And then, as I said before, feather designs are very spectacular when they really go around the corner. There's no point doing feather designs straight. I mean, you can do, but they're not as spectacular. But when you go around the corner, on the other hand, there is a quite significant difference to them. So we're going to do the same thing. We're going to press it down over here. We let it ride a little bit on the tip, drag for a little bit, and when we're happy with it, then you press down. And once you're releasing that pressure, you're going to go towards the centerpiece again. And you get this very distinctive feather piece, especially when you go step down. So let's say we're going halfway through, or maybe three quarters way through, and we do the same thing on this end. So I press the tip down, let it ride a little bit, drag it for just a little bit. When I'm happy with it, I press down, and when I'm going down, going toward the centerpiece. And again, smaller over here, ride it a little bit on the tip, press it down, and go towards the center. And a couple more over here, tip down, down, and ride towards the center. And you can straight away see this is different design than the teardrop we had before. And that's when the scrolling, you can develop the good control over the scrolling, you know, extra bits and bobs on the side. But I'm going to tell you and show you how to use it in the next video, next episode. But this is a good thing to practice right now before we get there. The way I'm trying to design these videos is showing you one thing at a time. So next week or next 2 weeks, whenever I have time to upload the next video, you already practiced that. And I don't need to explain you how to do it. We can just carry on with something else. And all this is going to make sense soon. I'll show you. Going to give you a different angle of the same thing. So once again, a little bit of the paint from the tip is knocked off, but don't go crazy. You want to paint in there, but you don't just want so much that it drips of it. Yeah, so once again, press the tip down, let it ride for a little bit. Well, I'm happy with it, I press the whole thing down. Once I'm pulling, I release that pressure a little bit. If you're not happy with the shape of the tip, come back to it a little bit and fix it up. You know, there's no reason, there's no rule why you cannot do that. You can make it a little bit fatter if you want to. You cannot make it any skinnier, you know, that's like with cutting. But you can make it fatter if you want to, that's no problem there. Then again, I'm going on the left and the right side. So I'm going like three quarters of the way down, press the tip of my brush, let it ride a little bit, and then press it harder down. And once you pull in and release in, you go towards that center design over here and release the pressure. And the same thing on the other side. Press the tip, let it ride a little bit, then you press it down, and once you release in, you go towards the middle of design. And so on and so forth over on the other side. Ride the tip, press down, pull, release the pressure. And same over here. Tip, press, right, curve, release. It's a very satisfying process, especially when the design comes together. And once you get very efficient with that, you love these designs. They really fly, they really make everything just a little bit lighter. Painting on the heavy motorcycles, throwing this design across the petrol tank or on the side, it gives it wings, it really does, it uplifts everything up. So more or less this is what you're going for, just kind of designs at the moment with a center line made of the same thing. Yeah. Maybe I'll give you one more ride over here to take you for a ride with me. So once again, the feather drop design is same as a teardrop, but you press the tip down, you get it ride for a little bit. When you're happy with it, then you press the whole thing down, then you go down and release that pressure. And the magic happens when you go around the corners, and it's the same procedure. Tip of the brush down, let it ride a little bit, slide, drag along, then you press down, and then you go around the corner, yeah? And you release that pressure, and same thing over here. Go about halfway through or three quarters way through. Don't go same distance, that's not gonna look right. I mean, you can do if you wanna practice it. By all means, that's probably a good idea. To make them all the same, if you wanna corner it, why not? But they always look better in the actual design when you go three quarters or even halfway down. So you press it down, right, then you put the pressure and release the pressure when you go around the corner. This is how it goes. This is how it gets done, yeah. Boom. Yeah, so I'm hoping these previous exercises are gonna make it a little bit more interesting for you to practice your brush control rather than painting straight lines and C curves and S curves. It's a bit more fun because you got like a little mini designs building up along the way, and you can make them look more pretty and more exciting every time you do it. But there's one more trick I want to show you in the end of this video. It's something they call it the weed design, I think. I think it's either weed design or a straw design, or I'm not quite sure what the professional name for it is, but it looks quite cool, and I want to show you how to paint one. So it's a basically combination of the previous two with some simple line around it. It's simple as that. So what I want you to do is there are two or three ways of doing that. I'll show you three of them right now quickly, just so you can go ahead and practice them at home. So one way is going to be, let's say, downstroke, as we practiced so far. So you want to press that, do it like a mini teardrop design. You press that quite hard and then immediately release and do like a really sharp tear point on it, so it looks like a teardrop, like a very small teardrop. Yeah, once we get this, you go on the back of that and basically draw a line, very thin line. Yeah, and that's a weird drop, or if you name it. If the tip is not as sharp as you want it to, just come back to it and fix it a little bit. Much better, right? So that's one way of doing it. The other way of doing it, it's going to be the opposite direction, because sometimes you just don't have enough room to do it this way. So what do you want to do? You knock off some paint of your tip, as we did before, and start thin and go fat. So you start on the tip, and once you go in, you press hard, and without pulling the brush, just release it. And you got pretty much the same design over here. And then what you need to do, just draw a line. So it's another weed design. It looks very much like that. It just done a little bit differently. Once again, not happy with the shape of it? Come back and fix it up a little bit. What's stopping you? And last one, the last way, or the third way of doing the weed design is just by this single stroke, single brush stroke. So let's say I'm starting with a line, do a just regular scroll design, and I'm gonna, once I finish that line, I'm gonna press the brush down hard to achieve that weed effect, and then release it again. Let's have a look if I can pull it here. reflection, but there you go, it's done. I prefer to do it this way, but I understand at first it may be quite difficult. Just drawing the heads first and then pulling lines out of them is absolutely fine. The result is the same, so I don't see any difference really. Let's have a look again. I'll give you another angle of the same design. So starting my just regular circular line, tip down, brush 90% 90 degrees down to the board, and just go for it. And when you go down, you press hard, stop, and then you pull it out. Yeah, the key is to, when you pull in that line, when you're ready to make your final design, you slow down to near stop and then immediately press that brush heavy and don't really pull it out, just kind of let it leave the board gently, because if you press it down and you're going to pull, then you're going to achieve really long effect, which is probably not bad in some ways. In some designs it's going to work just fine, as long as it's not too long, as long as you not do it like a really long teardrop or a feather design. But in the pen, again, it's pinstriping. The beauty of it is very, very free art form, and there are no rules and no boundaries. So you invite things as you go. When you pull in that design and you pull in that line, nothing is written. There's no rules. And the beauty of it, as I said, it's halfway through a design, you can decide that you want to change that line direction and you want to go a different way, just because it looks better. And you always go with your heart, always go what feels like, what feels right. And that is beautiful. One of the beauties of pinstriping, nothing is set in stone. It's your artistic interpretation of what you want to do and how you want to express yourself. One of the reasons I love this art form.
There we go, guys. That's another successful lesson, hopefully successful lesson done for today. Next video, we're going to build a full-on scroll design using our circular lines and our feather designs as well, and teardrops, and maybe some feather wheat drops, you name it. We're going to use all these fancy techniques we learned today with the techniques we learned on the previous episode about scrolls, and we try to build full-on blown scroll, maybe two or three colors, see how that goes. So do practice what we did today, because next week you need to catch up, stay up to speed. Once again, as always, thank you very much for all your kind comments and all your messages. Same goes for this guy. You got any questions about pinstriping or giraffes, I guess, drop me an email. Drop me a message, comment underneath, find me on Facebook, on Instagram, you name it, you know where to find me, everything is out there. So get in touch and I'll be more than happy to help. It's free, so why not? Alright guys, that's it for this week. I'll see you next time.